welcome family, friends, and loved ones. My name is Judge Peter Culkin, and I'm a judge of the Newburgh City Court. I've been a close friend of Kate's father, Rob, for over 40 years. I've known Kate her whole life. I could not be happier to be conducting this ceremony for Kate and Ryan as they take the next step in their lives together. We're gathered here today to unite Kate and Ryan in lawful matrimony. You've come here to share in the formal commitment they make to one another, to offer your love and support to this union, and to allow Kate and Ryan to start their married life together, surrounded by the people dearest and most important to them. From the beginning to the most recent page, the annals of human history reveal the transcendent importance of marriage, lifelong union of a man and a woman. Has always been promised nobility and dignity to all persons without regard to their station in life. Marriage is sacred to those who live by their religious and offers unique fulfillment to those who find meaning in the secular realm. Its dynamic allows two people to find a life that cannot be found alone, for a marriage becomes greater than just the two persons. Rising from the most basic human needs, marriage is essential to our most profound hopes and aspirations. The centrality of marriage to the human condition makes it unsurprising that the institution has existed for millennia and across civilizations. Since the dawn of history, marriage has transformed strangers into relatives, binding families and societies together. Confucius taught that marriage lies at the foundation of government. This wisdom was echoed centuries later and a half a world away by Cicero, who wrote, "The first bond of society is marriage, next children, and then the family." There are untold references to the beauty of marriage in religious and philosophical texts, spanning time, cultures, and faiths, as well as in all forms of art and literature. The marriage ceremony has been an important feature across all these references. We have thousands of important moments that happen throughout our lives, but marriage is regarded as one so critical that we acknowledge its special status by sharing it with others. Why this moment? Because despite all of our differences, love is what we all share. It's the great unifier, our one universal truth, that no matter who we are, where we've come from, what we believe, we know this one thing: love is what we're doing right. That's why you both are standing here. That's why we are all here to watch them stand together. We've all loved in our lifetimes, and in this moment, we're reminded that the ability to love is the very best part of humanity. What this ceremony will do is affirm the choice you make to stand together as life mates and partners. Kate and Ryan have some vows they would like to read to each other. Ryan?
You complete me. I promise to be faithful and honest in every way. I truly believe that you don't love someone for their looks or their clothes, but because they sing a song only you can hear. I'll always listen to you sing, for together we are greater than the sum of our parts. I've known that every day since we met, and each day we'll continue to discover that together. I'll never leave you. I'll stand with you for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness or in health, as long as we both shall live. I will keep on reaching for the stars with you together in love, but only with you can I keep my feet on the ground.
Okay.
I promise to be faithful and honest in every way. I truly believe that you don't love someone for their looks or their clothes, but because they sing a song only you can hear. I will always listen to you sing, for together we are greater than the sum of our parts. I've known that every day since we met, and each day we'll continue to discover that together. I'll never leave you. I will stand with you, for better or for worse, for richer and for poorer, in sickness and health, as long as you both shall live. I will keep on reaching for the stars with you, together in love, but only with you can I keep my feet on the ground.
Ryan, take the ring and repeat after me. I, Ryan, who place this ring on your finger as a continual sign that we are married.
I, Ryan, do place this ring on your finger as a continual sign we are married.
I will cherish and love you at all times and under all circumstances.
I will cherish and love you at all times and under all circumstances.
I will keep only unto you for as long as we both shall live.
I'll keep only unto you as long as we both shall live.
You take Kate to be your lawful wedded wife?
I do.
Take the ring and repeat it after me. I, Kate, do place this ring on your finger as a continual sign that we are married.
I, Kate, place this ring on your finger as a continual sign that we are married.
I will cherish and love you at all times and under all circumstances.
I will cherish you at all times and under all circumstances.
I will keep only unto you for as long as we both shall live. You take Ryan to be your lawful wedded husband.
I do.
As you wear these rings, whether you are together or apart, let your rings serve as a constant reminder of the promises you are making today. You've shown your love and affection by joining hands and have made promises of faith and devotion to each other. You have sealed these promises by the exchange of vows. No union is more profound than marriage, for it embodies the highest ideals of love, fidelity, devotion, sacrifice, and family. In forming a marital union, two people become something greater than they once were. Marriage embodies a love that may endure even past death. By the authority vested in me by the state of New York, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Thank you. Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me.
Like to give a special thank you to Rob and Debbie. I don't see Rob.
Here I am.
Rob and Debbie, who are Katie's parents, for giving my son a most wonderfully beautiful, intelligent, compassionate young lady.
Yay.
Who has now become his wife, and I am proud to say my daughter-in-law. So thank you, Rob and Debbie, for that. As far as our bride and groom, Brian and Katie, may your marriage be filled with happiness that grows, with love that endures, and a life filled with prosperity and good health always. Thank you.
The bride was a day, the dark said.